So, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. For those who do not know me, I am Yasa Sapugada, Managing Sales Administration in UTE. And I will be the moderator for the evening. I would like to warmly welcome all of you for the webinar of Understanding Power Quality and its latest technology organized by UTE Learning Center. The forum will highlight some of the main pain points that the industry will and are facing in relation to power, such as voltage fluctuations, quality of power, effects from power, sudden power loss, and other main concerns. The key speaker for the evening is Mr. Sumesh Nair, a postgraduate with Master's in Advanced Electronics from University of Pune, with an experience with more than 24 years in the power electronics industry, presently working in the capacity of Head of Exports in Fuji Consol near Wat, India. Before inviting the resource person, I will give a brief introduction about UTE Innertrakt Equipment Private Limited. UTE is a 37-year-old company in the engineering field. One thing that we have learned during our extensions is the market means the importance of after-sales support. UTE have invested in a fully-fledged service facility and concerned in maintaining inventory of critical parts in order to help and support our clients to continue their operations smoothly. I would also mention about our tagline, which is "The journey continues long after the sale." In other words, UTE believes and emphasizes on improving and offering our best service to our clients. Also, UTE is a one-stop solution provider for construction, warehousing, and power-related equipments, where we will provide products and solutions for your requirements in the mentioned field. So, about the process on the webinar today, I would like to request everyone to please mute your mic. And if you have any questions or doubt, please feel free to drop a message to the chat during the session, and we would reply to the main concerns during the Q&A segment. Now, I would like to invite Mr. Sumesh to share his knowledge with all of us. Sumesh, over to you.
Hello. Thank you. Thank you, Assess. And I welcome you all on Shilangi LC Ayub Bhuvan. So there's a big namaste to everyone from India. Thank you everyone for giving this time in the evening, because we all are busy with our families after the office hours are done. So this 1 hour of sessions, we will try to have a talk on the topic which says understanding power quality and its latest technology. So this is brought to you by the main Fuji Electric Japan, whose one of arm is in India. And we operate for SAR companies from India. And we are proud to say that we are servicing our products and services through UTE, which is one of the legends company in Sri Lanka. So I begin with this. Would you please allow me to share the Yeah, thank you. Yes, sir. So presently we have 39 participants, including the participants from UTI. So I'll put up my video so that the bandwidth is there. So if you have anything, questions on topic, on anything, on any issues, if you want to talk about the rains are going to come there tomorrow or not, let us talk. So I'm free for that. And for that, the chat box is there and you can always interrupt me and Mr. Yasus can respond or myself can respond. Thank you. So I'll put on my video. So I would be sharing my content now. That is the presentation on the present quality of power, what you can have and what the Fuji Electric Japan can offer you. So I think my screen is visible to you. So this is a topic we are talking about in next 40 to 45 minutes. I will be brushing up few topics fast understanding that we all are industrial people with a minimum qualification to understand what is power, what is quality, what is reliability, and what is performance. So going ahead with that, we are talking about power. So we have two coined, when you talk about power, we have two things about it. One is power and one is, second is energy. Energy is a bigger concept wherein it deals with a lot of energies in terms of hydraulic energies, in terms of nuclear energy, in terms of electrical energy, in terms of mechanical energies. So we are confined here to power quality. Power means only confined to electrical energy power. So it is, this topic governs about understanding power quality management, its reliability and performance. So we'll go ahead with the presentation. So we have here, let me minimize this. Okay. So I'm represented by and interested by a company which is there in this technology front for last 97 years. And in 2023, we will be 100 years old company, Fuji Electric Japan. It's synonym to quality, it's synonym to Japan. Now this company is progressing its own arm, only focusing in power industry. It has an establishment head office in Tokyo, and presently the net sale, the figures are $9 billion. So it's a big company which has established for the 100 years, $9 billion. It has earned its name and its money and its trust to its customers. How it does it? It is about the employees. We have 27,000 plus employees, which is out of which 35% is overseas and rest is in Japan. So you can see that, you know, Japan is looking out from Japan to serve their quality product to the world. So that is the first step which is the Fuji has taken to work in SAARC company in the SAARC countries in the peninsula of India, with establishing with Fuji Consul Neo right now. We have a global network of 97 sales base. We have 53 manufacturing bases across the globe. Products spread to 96 countries and 13 countries are in Asia. So out of 96, 13 are in Asia, which is more than 15%. So talk about the network. We have 8 networks in Europe, which is in France. We have measurement and control devices. Then Fuji fuel cells, which is a specific renewable energy branch, which is looking into these technologies, which is there in Europe. Then we have 7 network in America, which is working in turbine services, which are always in SEMEC, which is there in steam turbine and generations, which is in US and Canada. Then we have 18 network in China, because China is one of the largest country in the Asia. So we have a largest network there, although there is a differences between China and Japan, but yes, we do have some network there because of the political issues we are established there. But if you see the flags are there, and we would like the flag of Sri Lanka to be there, but presently we are operating from India and we have 46 networks other than China in Asia itself. So moving ahead with the 68 network, we are very clear Japan want to expand and give its quality right from the cars to the electronics to the background of technology. When you talk about Fuji Electric credentials in SAARC countries, what we have is in SAARC country, the present establishment in India is 35 plus years of experience, which is equivalent to the history of power electronics in Asia. I remember when I was small, I used to listen to Ceylon Radio, which was in 1970s. And we were hooked to those radios, even when we had our own Indian air to, you know, give the radio signals. But that was almost 30, 35 years back. So we are established in power electronics in 35 years. And we know what is the electronics and power electronics talks about in the world. We have 4 lakh installation and plus 300 plus customers in SAARC countries which are using 1 megawatt of power, which we have minimum of 1 megawatt, which one of the customer is in Sri Lanka. We are proud to say that Ansel Sri Lanka is using close to 1 megawatt. It is 960 kVA of power they're using for UPS industry, which we are established as with the strength of UT's engineering capabilities. Moving ahead, we have 25 plus sites locations in India and around, as well as we in Bangladesh, Nepal, and with our partners, we have 100 plus channel partners who are qualified for doing the service support to our customers. We have 10,000 plus customers in SAARC countries. Of course, we have a global network. If you consider Fuji as a total basket, it is different. This is, we are talking only for power quality. We have 80 plus service locations, 400 plus service engineers in India to support the installations, India, plus the countries which are associated in the Indian Peninsula, which is Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, and Nepal prominently. Present in India, we have 1,000 employees. As I said, globally, Fuji has 27,000 plus employees, 4 factories in India, and we have a DSIR, that is Department of Science for Research and Development approved industry in India. Is there a question? I heard something. Okay. So, why we are in this business? Why now the power quality people are in business? I'm talking business in terms of solutions, not in terms of making money. Of course, that is a secondary part of it. But why we are in need for you as a customer? So when you talk about a power requirement, power is generally transmitted from a high turbine area, which you have you may have a hydro power, you may have a nuclear power, you may have a hydro power. So from there, you will start generating the high level of voltages, which is of 800 kVAs and 400 kVAs line. And that will transmit a low current transmission to a substation of 220 kVA or 132 kVA. Then you will step down to 33 kVA. This is basics. And then finally, the consumers, where either you're sitting now into the homes, where you have single phase supplies, and into the factories in the mornings, we are into the industries. So this is the area where we are seeing this power being transmitted. But the whatever is transmitted, that is, this is like a god which is giving you all kind of resources, but we are not receiving the same resources at your end. There are many reasons why it is not. So what the problems we have at consumer or customers level, these are these problems, the power quality problems we have. One is the mains interruptions. If you go towards Dubai, if you go towards the power rich countries like Europe and Americas and Dubai and some part of Japan, maybe China, Russia, you will never find on the main cities I'm talking about, the power interruptions, that is power failure is not there. SAG and burnouts, they are not defined in those countries. But in our countries where we are living in developing countries like us, we have these all problems, interruptions, SAG and brownouts. That means you have voltages falling 90% and below. Transients, which is the, because of overshoot, there are industries which is having mixed inductive load and capacitive loads. You have this kind of waveforms seen into your networks. You have high frequency noise, which is generally noted EMI and EMCs, that is electromagnetic inference and conductions. Then we have the causes are jotted down on your right column. We have something called harmonic distortion. This is the biggest threat in an industry called the generation industry, wherever you are generating and consuming. Because of the load consumption, this harmonic distortion comes, which is generally because of the nonlinear loads. So this is one of the problems seen in the network. Frequency variations is because of the generation site, which is reducing its cycles. If the loads are more and the generation is less, the frequency will drop. If the load is less and generation is more, frequency will go up. So you can see for our kind of center frequency of 50 hertz, you might see the frequency going at 47, 48 at times when there is no load. And when there is high load, you can see, when there is a high load, then it will go at 47 to 48 hertz. When there is no load, it may go to 52 to 53 hertz also. So this variations is not constant because the load pattern has not been secured. Then you have swells. So why I have highlighted these two things? These two things we have now, we have very now in Colombo, in the metro cities in India, or in Dhaka, or in Kathmandu in Nepal, we can find almost these things are eliminated, but we will always have sags and swells. That is, this is because of the, you know, poor network connections. When we talk about these substations, if the substations are built 50 years old or 40 years old, the equipments are not been enhanced to take care of all the latest load requirements. So that's why these two factors come into picture, that is sags and swells. And of course, the frequency variation and harmonic distortion is a part of it. So this is the main power quality issues what we are always catering with. So moving ahead, we all are aware this is the problem. So we are there in the business. So what is the impact and the solution over this power problems? Now, the generation companies who are generating the power in the hydropower, if it is a hydropower, if it is a coal-based power or a nuclear power, they are generating a pure sine wave output according to the required frequency. But because of the transmission issues and because of the infrastructure issues, we are not able to get the similar kind of characteristic at your consumer end. So what a body of the association has done, that you have to make your equipment susceptible to take some kind of abuse due to this problem. So these curves, which is defined as semi-curves, ITICS, and there is something called CDMA curve. CDMA is the Computer Design Manufacturing Association, which defines these curves. What they say is that if equipment is connected to the power supply in single phase or three phase mode, so everywhere if you can see that it is against the time and it is away in the nominal voltage from the 90% to 10% of drop. So everywhere it is a nominal voltage and is your duration of the cycle. So your, if it always talks about between 15 to 30 milliseconds. So if you talk about a sine wave of 50 hertz, one cycle is equal to 20 milliseconds. So they always define that this 20 millisecond, your equipment should not have understand that is an interruption, either with swag, sag or swell or a power on. So these all talk about it. These all curves I have concluded in one slide to understand this is the equipment manufacturing's responsibility to manufacture. That's why if your computer is having a flicker of 20 milliseconds, it will not reset. So that is how they have built up their own circuit. So that is from the consumer ends. So this is what they have done. SMPS, which is the primary source of any computers. PLC is the primary source of any processor unit. VFD, which is variable frequency drive, is a primary source for any driving motor or any heavy equipment. So there always they say 20 to 100 milliseconds. 20 milliseconds is common in all these kind of industrial load as well as commercial loads. So we have to take care about these variations and the power out conditions. So this is the implementation consumers have taken from the point of view of producing the power equipments. But there are still many equipments which are very sensitive, which cannot take even 5 milliseconds of break. So there we need to have a continuous power without any break. So what we have issue, what do we have the solutions for these problems? We have mains interruption. There are, I have highlighted 7 of them. So out of which, this is what we have done it from the point of view of manufacturing the equipment or the products which you are going for the processes. But there is a gap between the power utility and consumption. So where we have to put certain equipment to correct it. So first and foremost, which is the age old thing, is stabilizers. So what stabilizer does it? These are two factors, that is SAG. That means if your voltage is reducing below 90% for a duration of more than 100 milliseconds, and for a swell, it is overshoot of voltage, which is more than 100 milliseconds. So these two conditions, the equipment can malfunction, longer working period time, reduce the performance as well. And there will be some computational error if it is going to do any kind of analysis. So these two are the basic problem if you omit about interruptions, harmonics, or spikes, or any kind of surges. So when we talk about these two, which is a common thing in your commercial household things, as well as in industry. That is why you are always recommended to have a voltage stabilizer when you buy a TV, we call it as panels, which is LCD panels, or if you have a refrigerator, or that time when we have VCRs and VCPs, those are antique pieces now. But we used to connect one small stabilizers to take care about these two swells and sags. So what is stabilizers? It is nothing but an automatic voltage regulator. In electronic language, we regulate the voltage. So for that, if we have two, it's a single phase input, we have transformers with primary and a secondary winding with certain taps in it, with a tolerance in it. So this tap will be a very crude way of stabilizing the power. It will step from one voltage to other voltage, depending on the feedback given from the input voltage. So this is a basic crude thing, which is generally done for a single phase supply. But for the industry, then we have something called buck boost transformers along with, instead of the tap changes, we go into here, we have a motorized control, which that arm will move on the winding of this transformer. So you know that if you have a transformer of certain ratios from primary to secondary, the ratio of the turns will define you the voltage amplification or drop. So you choose the tapping point and you can select the voltage which you want for the load. So depending on the buck boost transformer, buck means you have to reduce from higher to lower. Boost means you have to increase from lower to higher. So this transformer will sense the voltage which is coming from input and will buck or boost to this secondary transformer, which is in series with the buck boost transformer. And it's one of the limb will be controlled by your servo motor, which is controlled through a feedback mechanism. And this is how you control it. So now the sluggish part becomes this servo motor. How fast this servo motor can react, that will tell you that how fast is the slew rate. That is a technology word which we are using it for response against the input variation to the correction of the output. So this will become a very crucial method for a servo control voltage stabilizer. So to improve that, there is something called static voltage stabilizer, wherein we have removed this servo motor and we have put an IGBT controlled and along with the microprocessor. So there are two technologies for the three-phase industry which can control your voltage for sag and swells. Okay. So when you talk about servo control stabilizers, the motor is fitted on the top and this is the winding. So this motor will touch the carbon brush inside and to the secondary and it will decide the voltage. And whereas there is another called linear type, wherein the arm will move up and down. Instead of this is a circular path. It will go inside and it will touch the secondary path. Whereas in linear type, it will touch on a horizontal vertical side and it will touch the copper points wherever the correction is required. But the only thing is that the problem with the linear type is that you need to have three windings for the three phase, whereas you can have a three phase winding done for the toroidal transformer here. It's a technology in transformer. Whereas in this, you will have three windings for three phase. So there, your unbalancing is only restricted to 30 to 40%. Whereas in this, you can have 100% unbalancing it. So this is why you see a lot of dimmer type of variacs in static voltage stabilizer in the industry than the linear type. Linear type can be seen in a very commercial place where there is no variation of the load. But in industry, there is a lot of load. So we will consider only dimmer type of variacs. Moving ahead, I talked about buck boost. What buck boost says, buck says that if the applied voltage is input voltage is higher, then primary voltage minus the secondary voltage with the applied voltage So that means it has to reduce the voltage when it is buck function, and boost function, it has to increase the voltage. So this is an example we have shown in this. So this is a typical mechanism of servo voltage controller. So there is a mechanical assembly inside. There's a motor which has a feedback mechanism, and it is the feedback is done through a PWM technology, which is pulse width modulation, and that is controlled through a small microcontroller, and that drives this motor. So you have got the quality of microcontroller which is driving this motor. So the sluggishness of the feedback mechanism is taken over by faster digital control. So that is about SCVS, which is servo control voltage stabilizer main components. So we talked about what stabilizer is. So basically operating principle is it works in buck boost transformer primary, which is there. And the secondary arm is moved by a servo controller. And this control panel is through a microprocessor, which will enable the movement of the servo controller to the precise requirement of the load requirement. So the voltage regulation and load regulations are controlled by these mechanisms. This is a gist of this slide. I'll move ahead. So what Fuji Console NeoVat is offering you from SCBS, this is a primary source for power controlling. We have air-cooled stabilizers which are rated up to 300 kV capacities. So that means there is an electronic function and there are fans to cool the inside of the mechanism. So this works with the variation of minus 50 to 40% also. And at the higher end, you can go to plus 30% also. So this has a different variations. We can offer you with isolation transformer and with buck boost transformers inbuilt, and with the variation of input of plus or minus 40%. 50% is an optional feature. Then we talk about the product which is going above 300 kV. When we talk about in a megawatt scale, that is 3.5 megawatt capacity. This is the picture which is shown you. It's a real picture of a 3.5 megawatt which we have supplied across the globe. It's an oil-cooled stabilizer. So the name says that whatever the heat generated while doing the correction, the cooling mechanism is not air, it is by oil. So the transformer, the buck boost transformer is dipped into the oil, and there are fins which will cool it. And the same kind of output you will get it, what you get in air cool. But it is an outdoor unit. You can install it outside your factories, which you are aware about. So this all gives you ultimately stabilizes when you operate any equipment in the constant voltage condition. Your current consumption is also constant. It is not going to vary too high when there is a low voltage, because it's a dual nature, Ohm's law. When the voltage drops, the current goes high as the resistance of the impedance of the your factory is going to same. So your current is the main thing which is governing to your metering requirements, which is a kVA metering or kilowatt metering. So depending on that, your energy conservation for even lighting or the smallest load can be, you know, reduced. We have seen the reduction on the power is almost to close to 25-30% of saving. Then we have also got isolation transformer, which is K-rated transformers and ultra-isolation transformer, and even it can mitigate harmonic requirements to up to 13 level also. So moving ahead, this is about stabilizers. So we have taken about sags and swells. These are the two things we talked about for stabilizers. Now, what is the solution for maintenance interruption, transient, frequency noise, frequency variations? We'll talk about harmonic distortion the latest time. So there is something called UPS, which is a very matured term in the industry. In the electrical industry, everybody knows it. Probably most of us will be using this kind of supply in the home. It is known as inverter at times. It is known as power backup inverter, or sometimes UPS, that is uninterruptible power supplies. So this is, as the name points, you have uninterruption in the power, whatever is the situation at the generation end. The Fuji console NeoWire gives you an option in single phase online UPS, which is coined with the name Finch, PW and Finch RT. This is in single phase, we have available till 10 kVA of requirements. So if you see these pictures, they are real pictures of the products. So you can have it with single phase input, single phase output, three phase input and single phase output. Generally, we market, of course, these UPSs are very specifically designed for healthcare, where you have even X-ray machines, you have gas chromatography into your pharma companies, or you have an ITIDS, server racks or data centers, or BFSI is a bank and financial institutes where you have, again, ATM machines, you have note counting machines, you have servers, government infrastructure, again, you can have a CCTV network, you have safety equipments or fire alarms. So all these critical equipment can be clubbed for these kind of applications. So that is how we have said this is designed for banking, ATM, medical industries, network with a single power output requirements. Generally for these backup systems are defined for a smaller backup. It may go from 5 minutes to 20 minutes. If you require an extra more than that, then you need to build up a different product with a higher charging capability. So that we also, Fuji is offering you. So single phase, this is a mass product which is given for all the industries pertaining to the end customers which I have highlighted here. So in short, we have PG, which is three phase output, three phase input, then three phase input and single phase output. Then these are terminologies. IT means along with isolation transformer. So certain places wherein you have X-ray machines or you may have a gas chromatography machines where you require a perfect galvanic isolation, there we can provide you Finch PW. Then sometimes you have a small office where you require built-in batteries for 5-10 minutes of backup. You have BIB, which is built-in batteries. So we have this certain ranges right from 1 kV to 30 kV available. So basically this topology is online double conversion without galvanic isolations. When we talk about without IT, PW is without isolation. Input power factors correction is up to 0.99. You do not have to correct this. Auto bypass facilities there. This is can be a single phase input and output can be configured. If it is a three phase input and single phase output, it can be reconfigured for a single phase input also. So that is the beauty of this topology. Up to 10 kV we are saying, not above that. Charging current and it's a constant voltage, constant current. And it can protect, it has a protecting circuitry for battery. You can cold start with the battery without any grid input. You can start the system directly on battery. Battery release with the protections for the battery sake of it. And there's a battery test which can take care about the battery life requirement. Additional features is main thing I'll highlight is eco. The eco mode wherein you can get the highest efficiency in the UPS and also it can work with different input voltage settings depending on your load connectivity. So at 200, 208, there are different settings. You can do it on, from your LCD display. Apart from that, you have monitoring protocol, which is LCD and SMPS and input manual bypass, wherever there is a requirement of bypass connection. So you can have a correction by using a manual bypass. So this is the Finch product, which is from 1 to 10 kV, both in single phase and three phase products. So in short, this is the how the system looks. You have a provision to put batteries down in certain ratings and those cooling fans are separately given for that. And the electronics are on the top. So it is an integrated isolated transformer option. If you want to have an isolation transformer, instead of the battery, we'll put the transformer here. So the design is very flexible. So you can have an external battery connector, communication port is there, intelligence slot is there, emergency power off is there, cooling fan options are there. I mean, you talk about user-friendly requirement, it is all there. It's a plug-and-play kind of system. You need not to have an expert to install these systems. So you, this is the manual wiper switch. These are the fuses, given at the input breakers, which is given. So there's a protection from input and output breaker. So this is a basic product profile in terms of how it appears. It has a wheels also. You can move this product. It's lightweight. Then you have Finch PG, which is a three-phase product, similar kind of features, 10 to 30 kVA, similar kind of product. So it's this is how it looks in three-phase. So the front display will give you entire history of the product and its features. It can talk about the battery levels, battery time information, general alarm, buzzer off, input value, UPS operation mode. So if you have in mind, if it is in double conversion mode, it will give you efficiency close to 94%. And if you go to eco mode, it will give you efficiency close to 95.5%. Output values, that is, it will give you current voltage and frequency, short circuit warning, that is the fault conditions, low battery warning, again fault condition, battery mode indicator. So it will talk about how much is your battery indication through this LED. So on a one look, you can find out the health of the product, and it is a very user-friendly kind of product which can be connected by any non-technical person also. So this is up to 30 kVA product, which we have for specifically for healthcare, IT, ATS, BFSI, which I have mentioned in my slides earlier. It has got a remote monitoring facility. You can sit at anywhere in the world and you can check the status of your UPS by connecting it through an HTTPS server. So there's a password ID with a password protocol. You can connect that and you can understand what is your UPS doing and what is the health of the UPS sitting anywhere in the world. This is remote monitoring, but if you do not have to go out of your office, you have local monitoring also. So you can see elaborate thing, how the energy is transferring, how the performance is done on the UPS. So these are optional features which we give if the clients are requiring, we provide these things and these are available with the equipment itself. Then we have something called Finch RT. This is a very sleek UPS model. It looks like your old VCR and it can fit into 19-inch rack. Generally, IT, ITS person will understand the importance of this width we are talking about. It can go into your 19-inch rack. It can be connected without any problem. It's like a tray which is going into your shelf. So it has the same features. It has efficiency of 96%. You can parallel up to four systems. It is available in 6 and 10 kilowatts. So 4 means 24 kilowatt and 40 kilowatt is available for you, along with the same features of ecosystems and SNPS. So this efficiency of 95 to 96% is achieved by using three-level technology. So this I'll speak in a later form. The advantage to you is that when you have a lower voltage condition at the input side, you reduce the load and work, make use of the system. So at 50% load, you can have 110 voltage at the input also with a nominal voltage of 230 or 240 volts. But if you have 100 voltage, it can also work at minimum at 165, which is almost minus 35% from your nominal voltage. So this is the green band where your system will not go into a battery mode. It will save the battery lives. So this is the most important feature for any power backup equipment to perform. So it can work from 110 volt at 50% load, and it can work up to 280 volts at 100% load with efficiency of 95% crest factor of 3:1. Yeah. So there we have. So this all will come with the input power management and my input ring. So this has all been done under the microcontroller, which we are using DSP, 32-bit DSP, which is programmed to work the power components in an efficient way by using these components in three-level technology, which is the latest technology for inverters. And if you can check on the Google also, you'll find how three-level technologies benefited against the earlier technologies, two-level technology. But there is not a way. There are also five-level technology, six-level technology, but those are very costly and thus they doesn't give much of benefit than what we are getting in three-level technology. Maybe five-level technology will give you more benefit when you increase the power of the scale of megawatt scale. This French RT, as I said, it can be parallel to four units. So this works that this is a paralleling. First unit is parallel to second. Second is to third. Third is to fourth. And the fourth is parallel to the one. So this is known as cyclic operation. So this can be configured for N plus one configuration. That means if out of four, one fails, the three of them will take care about the load without interruption. So one will always become a redundant supply. So if you have a 10 kV of requirement, so you will have 7.5 as a main load and 2.5 will be your resource load. So that is how you define it as N plus one configuration. So this is available up to 40 kV of supply. You can do it 10 into 4, 40 kV, you can assemble it in parallel. So we are generally where the data center have a critical requirement that nothing should fail. I should have some redundancy. So we can configure these four units of 10 kV in such applications. So this is all about efficiency and it is all about the performance of the systems. Then we come to three-phase systems. Apart from what we have discussed from Finch, we have three-phase system. Then we have Falcon series. This is very famous series, which is prominently working in Sri Lanka and all over in the globe. We have supplied 960 kV of supply in Encel, which is our proud installation for last 5 years. And we have installed two numbers of 400 kV there and one number of 160 kV, which is working since last 5 years without any problem. So this is a series Falcon 5000, which is having a transformer-based UPS. And we have a transformer-less UPS also for data center where the environment is very soothing. There we can deploy to 7000, but where the environment is very tough in terms of input power changeover, higher backup, and the load is non-linear, there we place 5000. Also 7000 can be placed to manufacturing also. But the fact is that thus equipments require a higher DC voltage, so your battery banks are more. So depending on your application, your requirement, we can provide you with transformer and without transformer also. The advantage of without transformer is that you get 1.5% efficiency more as compared to the transformer-based system. But advantage of transformer-based system is that you are getting a pure galvanic isolation between your source and your load. So there is additional protection to your load. So at no given point of time, the hazardous power cannot flow into it. So we have X5, which is the latest three-level technology in UPS. Then we have modular UPS of 7000M. And we have rugged manufacturing, only for manufacturing, which is up to 300 kVs. Falcon 8500. So we have segmented all these different industries. We have industrial requirement, which is manufacturing process, oil and gas, chemical, utility and power generation. What are the application areas? I'll share you the slide. I'll not go in elaboration because we don't have time. And this is the characteristic of UPS you should look into when you're going to buy for it. Similarly, for healthcare, these are the sub-market, that is hospitals, OEM, diagnostic center, hospitals, which are very critical in terms of human conditions are concerned. So these are the application areas which I've jotted down. These are the characteristic of the UPS which you should have. Then we come to the IT and ITS, where the environment is very soothing. You have an AC environment, office environment, where there is humans. So this is the application area we are going to do, where even the we can consider the banking area where branches and ATMs are there. So this is why characteristics of UPS is there. So as a power quality expert, we have given you a segmentation. We will be loving to share this with you for your knowledge proposition. So talking about the Falcon 8500, why I have chosen this product? Because this is the most rugged product you abuse it for any limit, it will perform to your requirement. So it can perform the main function, which I have not put, which is there. It can perform up to 40 degrees centigrade without any degradation. That means you do not have to give any kind of air conditioning to the environment of Indian Peninsula or Sri Lanka. It maximum you will have 1 or 2 days going to 45 degrees, but it will not have any effect on the performance. You don't have to degrade it. You don't have to put an air conditioning for these equipment to work. So this is equipped for a rugged condition. You put it in an environment where there is dust or where there is a garment factory or even for a environment, I will not say chemical factory, but then yes, if there is an environment where there is a steel factory and where there is garment of steel and the fabrication factory where there are certain particles which are floating in the environment, this product has a physical construction done according to that, and its internal temperature. Of course, all our equipments are defined for 40 degrees continuous performance, but this has the most the equipments can we have the history which wherein the systems are working for more than 12 years and with no issues we are able to maintain that systems also. So this is quite an user-friendly product which is used in medical, telecom, service, lift and escalators, infrastructure, industrial loads, regenerative loads. So the regenerative loads are the loads, for your information, most of you must be understanding this. Whenever the load is there, load will always demand power from the source. But at times in some loads, for the sake of their function, during the braking or releasing of the speed of the motor, they will emit or they will send a back EMF back to the source. So that is what is known as regenerative load. For example, if a lift is going up and down, so there is a reverse and forward mechanism of the motor. So whenever it has to brake from when it is coming from the top to down, in that braking mechanism, there is some EMF which is generated back to the source. So this is generally seen in such kind of, even for CNC machine application, these are seen. And so this is equipped for this kind of loads. So this is true industrial product, which is governed for the general requirement in Sri Lanka. And this is prominently working in the industry for last 10, 12 years. Then we have Falcon 5000. This is a little upgradation from Falcon 8500. What we have is, one is if you have input power factor is both a 0.9, but here the technology is IGBT, where this is ACR. So because of that, you get an input harmonic distortion in 5000 less than 5%. Whereas to be frank, in ACR based system, your harmonic distortion will be close to 30 to 35%. But for a larger industry, you don't have to worry about harmonic distortion when you have a connected transformer of more than 2.5 MVA and you are using a 300 or 500 kV UPS. Wherein if you have a small transformer which is connected and you're using a 500 kV, yes, you need to have an IGBT based input rectifier to reduce your harmonic to less than 5%. This is a difference. It is a high performance. Again, it can work to 40 degrees centigrade without an AC and with properly tropicalized in the humid environment. We have cards which are lacquer or which is treated for high humid requirements, which can work into coastal areas also. It is an inbuilt transformer. So the efficiencies are maximum up to 93%. So if you do not have transformer, I have product which is 7000, where efficiency goes to 95%. So it is the same product with 500 kV without transformer. All the features are same. It can also be used to load, but these products are having with a high DC voltage. So your number of batteries will increase here. You can see here 60 to 64 numbers. Whereas in this case, the DC voltage is up to 384 or 480 volts, that is maximum 40 batteries. So battery configurations are less as compared to 7000. Then you have X-series, which is a three-level topology. You will get more efficiency. And the main thing is that input voltage range can go up to minus 40% at 65%. So it is time inverse performance when there is an input variation, similarly to what we have seen in RT. So X5 can give you input power factor to 0.9. X7 is the product without transformer. This is with transformer and this is without transformer. So you can see the efficiency difference from 95.95, 1% difference is there between these two products. So if the customer wants high efficiency, you can go with X7 with a similar kind of topology, similar kind of features. But if you want to have an extra protection with isolation transformer, we do have that product with X5. So this is the latest technology the world is offering. In fact, Fuji is one of the company who is producing IGBTs. So these are, and Fuji is proud to be one of the inventors of insulated gate bipolar transistors in the world. So we understand the basics of the inverter, that is the component of the inverter, and that's how we are able to enhance into the technology. So no big companies in India are providing you with three-level topology, which we are talking about. So that gives you advantage of efficiency and input voltage range along with the performance. That is, performance is, if the sine wave is output THG is less than 0.1%, whereas in two level you can get the THG, the total harmonic distortion of voltage, less than 1%. So that is the difference in X series and the previous level of technology. And we have something called 7000M. This is, a lot of numbers are coming in, I'm sorry, but the time is less. I will not be able to elaborate much, but this M, known as modular product. So you have modules of 10 kilowatt, 25 kilowatts and 50 kilowatts. So you will have these modules stacked in vertical fashion to give you a maximum of 50 into 10. You can have 50 into 6. Like this, these are, you can parallel up to modules, you can make it 1500 kVA of output, that is 1.5 megawatts out of this. So you can have so many equipments in parallel. So you need not to wait for your load to increase. Once your load increases, you can increase the power module. So this is a typical scenario in a data center where we have a load depending on the server connected to it, the kind of computations is going on. Whereas in industry, the load is almost constant. If you have one line of industry where you are drawing an extrusion machine for blow film, or you are drawing, the wire drawing machine, or you are doing medical, tablet making machines where you are printing certain things, there are fixed loads. But if you talk about IT loads, today I have 100 people who are working for that IT company. Tomorrow I'll have 1,000 people. So that infrastructure will increase by exponential. So in that case, these modular products are used. That is the concept of modular UPS. So you can have in 10, 25 and 50 kilowatt range. With the features given here, your efficiency is 95.5%, is mountable on 19-inch rack. For IT people, they will understand. And it has a great, 10-inch TFT display, which will give you the entire health of the product. It's going to be, it's like a TV. Probably in some time, they will give you a Netflix connection also, so that you can watch a movie on that. Just jokes about. Then you come to Falcon 1000i. This is a typical industrial UPS, which generally we are supplying in Middle East, where there are oil rigs, where their conditions are very harsh. The temperatures goes to 55 to 60 degrees sometimes, and there are oil films. So this is a specific product which we are giving. It's a huge product. And if you see this size of UPS can be over 50 kV UPS, whereas in commercial, this size will be 500 kV UPS. So this is a custom built kind of product, right from 5 kVA to 60 kVA in single phase output we are giving for specifically for oil and gas, sugar, power, chemical and cement industries. The safety standard, we do have all IEC and ISO standards, which is governing for the quality which we produce from our factories, the safety qualities, testing performance, EMC, EMI, IP protections is there, noise level, quality standards is ISO 9001. We are having a latest 45,000 also. I forgot to mention that. Environmental management, we have 14,001. And we are CE marked from all the valuable institute across the world. Also, being an R&D center, our Indian government has given us recognition by saying that it is recognized by Department of Science and Industry Research of Research Government of India. So this has been recognized by Government of India. So we are doing a serious research as far as R&D is concerned. Now with Japanese intervention, we have good components to work on this also. So this India factory is going to be a global factory. At least for now, it is going to be a sourcing factory for SAARC countries with the quality of Japan. We have something called solar hybrid inverters, which is there in renewables. Apart from your issues, what we have for mainstream requirement, that is UPS. Now this is in renewables, as UT CAT is also providing you an online string, the string inverters, which are there generally for rooftop applications. I will not go into deep. So these are hybrid inverters which are available up to 450 kVA. This capacity no one gives in the world, let me say that with the proud. And this is what we have installed in a few of the applications, which is battery based, presently with lead acid. Now we are also putting this equipment with lithium ion applications also, which is going to be in megawatt scale. So this is the performance. These are available till 450 kilowatt. This is green in nature. You have certified with all efficiencies and for up to 95.5% efficiency. Rugged product with bi-directional inverter. If anybody has an interest on this, you can write it to UTE. We can come back to you with our solutions on it. We have very excellent solutions in terms of providing backup solutions without having dependency on any power, which is either from your utility or from your generator. So there is, we can have case studies where factories are working on solar power, but of course, the investment initial is little high, but it can give you a return of investment within 3 to 4 years when you are working against a generator set. But this will ensure you a clean power. So now we have something about power backup. Now how to sustain these backups? We are having certain switches called static transfer switches. So that is available in 2-pole, 3-pole and 4-pole. So this what switches generally does, when we talk about switch, it is either on or off. But in this switches are available in single phase, which is up to 63 amperes, and above 63 is three phase supply, which is up to 600 amperes. So what it does is, it takes two source, independent source, whichever is there in your premises. For example, if it's in hospital, they might have three floors or four floors. And on second and fourth floor, they have two UPS separately. But if, for example, if they have one load to have power backup, you need not invest into another UPS. Instead of that, just take cables from one source and second source and connect to this box. Depending on its rating, you can select this box and give a connection to your critical load. So what it will do is that it will intelligently select whichever source is healthy, it will use that source. So at the end of the day, the Lord will never understand that there is a power failure or interruptions. So you need not have any investment in extra UPS. You can use the capacities available in your spare UPSs on in your premises. So with this switches, only you have to put as one cable and maybe a isolator here to isolate the supplies for the sake of maintenance, and put this switch in between, and you can give it to the load. Of course, the source has to be constantly present. The next question people will arrive, can I put it between UPS and generator? No, because generator will come only when it is required. The source we should be always available. So you can have UPS 1 in some other floor, UPS 2 in some other floor. Like this, you can have these switches connected and you can power your critical requirements. Generally, these are used into data centers and IT requirements or into hospitals. For example, if there is an operation theater, a person can take the UPS supply from his MRI scanner, which because MRI scanner is not at all used every time continuously, and another from a maybe from outpatient requirement where there is a UPS. From these both UPS, it can take the power and ensure that there is a power available in the operation theater 24/7. So this is a very critical product which can you can also think about utilizing efficiently your UPS in your premises without investing into UPS and battery separately. It is available in three phase also, up to 400 amperes in four pole and up to 600 amperes in three poles. Then these are for the large installations of batteries. If there is a requirement of battery monitoring requirement, where there are spread out of hundreds of battery which needs to be checked and maintained, this is an extra provision which we have provided, which is intelligent battery monitoring. You can check each and every battery's health at any given point of time. So this is a description on that. I'll not go elaborate. If somebody is interested, please write to us. You can also, this intelligent battery monitoring can be checked on remote monitoring switch also. You can check it with TCP/IP protocol into your network system, WAN system, or through SNMP also. Then this is all about the problems which we have, sags and swags and swells and your power interruptions, which you generally see in your factory. But what you generally not see in your factory is harmonics. It's a very critical topic. Generally, it is a concern of the utility power, which is giving you a power supply, and rather than your as a consumption. But for example, if your industry utility power is set, you have to maintain the power factor above 9.99. Then you will put a capacitor so that you are not being penalized or there is no penalty. But there is going to be a norm where you have to also be taking a check on harmonics, how much is the garbage you are putting back into the utility. So this is what harmonics are about. So this is the green part which I've highlighted. What is harmonic is, if you have a fundamental frequency of 50 hertz, any the integral multiple of 50 is known as harmonics. So third harmonics will be 3 into 5, that is 150 hertz. Fifth harmonics will be 250 hertz. Seventh harmonics will be 350 hertz. So more elaborate on this harmonics, we can talk about in a separate topic if you're interested. But the fact is that this is the sine wave which your equipment requires. But because of harmonics, you're getting this sine wave, which is not the problem of the utility, but problem of consumers. So how to correct that, how to do it? We have a product called, so this is the different kind of loads which we have in the industry, which has generally converts AC into DC. And then that point of time, it will have a distortion. So this is how a network looks in the harmonic conditions. So these are the problems which generally, skipping it fast so that we have time for Q&A. So these are the generic problem of maintenance. I will understand that generator will have a underutilization, circuit breaker will have hit up, they will have to change it. There will be a wire burning without any reasons. You will be replacing those wires, but still you have the problem. So all these problems, which is dotted in black and white, has something called harmonics. Because of these harmonics, equipment functioning, it is an integral part of it. So these are the burnouts, actual photos, because of the harmonics we have seen, taken it. This is an issue which comes up in the industry. So there is a guidelines defined by IEEE 519. So which says that if your connected load is X and your demand load, which you can draw from the transformer, is X to Y. So Y by X is the ratio. On that ratio, you can define your harmonics. So harmonics will be defined on your type of industry you're running. So we have a product called active harmonic filter. So this, what it does, this is the block, and this is your load in short, and this is a source. So this harmonics, this is the harmonics current which is injected back to the sine wave, and you are not getting a pure sine wave here. So what it does, it has a feedback mechanism. It throws a feedback mechanism to the control system, and it generates a counter harmonic. That is a harmonic which is 180 degree phase shifted from what is it sees from the feedback mechanism. So it is a squad missile, which generally goes in correction technique. So whatever it sees, it inverts and gives it here, and you have a nullifying effect at the red point, which I'm showing here. So at the source end, you will not see any harmonics. So this sine waveform will be always sine wave. So this is the function of this harmonic filter. It's very simplified, told to you, but it is very complex because the equipment has to sense and correct in nanoseconds. Nanoseconds is 10^-9 of a second. So that is the speed of the device it has to correct. And you will get attenuation of 97% correction at the distribution level. So this is the technology we talked about, 2-level, 3-level, and what we are using, T-type. So the construction is modular. All the power equipments are separately stacked. There is electronics separately stacked. The PCB module is separate. So for maintenance, that is mean time to repair is less than 20 minutes. For any equipment of mine, you can just pull this out, put the equipment. Of course, your spares has to be there. Of course, if we do not have spare, then the time of spares coming to a site will be an additional cost. Additional time, sorry. So this is what we are having it, power module, PCB module, and all is stacked in one line. So this is the construction. We do it for UPS, for AHF, for bigger units, which are there in three phase of power units. Here's a specific design for an outdoor application where we have IP54 kind of requirement, where you can install this equipment on your rooftop also. So I'll skip all this. So the display of the IORA, which is a filter, is as equal to an oscilloscope. It will give you a waveform. It will give you all the readings, RMS reading. It will, by the touch screen, you can go to the section of the equipment and understand what is happening with the equipment. So you need not to have a separate meter to understand, to analyze these, your health of your factory's waveform at the LT level, PCC level. All these equipments are equally connected to all kind of remote monitoring, SNPS, GSM model, Modbus, even Profibus, even you have NetMax, any kind of connection, TCP/IP connections. We are having this compatibility to connect it to your networking system. So fine, that is all about the technology, what we are offering. This is, I think, 1% of what we are offering from India. There are many products Fuji is offering. I mean, if you talk about it, it will take 6 months for me to give a lecture on what we are offering. So this is 1 hour slot, or rather 45 minute slot, which I have overpassed. And this is the remote monitoring. And then these are the factories we are having in India. We have 4 factories, one in south, very close to Sri Lanka, which is in Chennai. 2 factories in the western part of India, which is in near Mumbai, 2 factories. and one in Delhi, the capital. So we have four factories in India, which are governing the entire product requirement for the SAARC countries. And these are the ISO certificates, what we have, which we qualify for global standards. These are a few of them I could accumulate in one slide. And most important is that we are associated with UTCAT. The prominent figure would be, let's say, is 1947, before independence. This company is established with a company called CAT, which is a prominent figure in the engineering field, which is Caterpillar. It is having 73 years of experience in engineering and services. It is five-star rated service and training facility. It is the only authorized partner for Fuji Electric Japan products for power electronics, for the power backup requirement, and Caterpillar. It has an excellent trained and service engineering workforce in the industry, and it has a beautiful training center in Colombo, which I have personally visited many times and appreciated them. What a place you have for young generation to come and see what technology is. And this partner landmark projects across Sri Lanka, winning trust of the countrymen with global standard. That is what is important. They are always, right from 70 years, they are always there with the technology, and they enhance the knowledge of people, of the countrymen, to go along with the technology. And I think in the development of Sri Lanka as one of the best ports in the Southeast Asia, which is definitely God grace, it should surpass the Singapore port in coming future. And this is, UT will be one of the prominent companies, engineering company, who's going to be a part of it. And I'm proud to be associated as a Fuji Electric Japan company who is serving with their products and services. So with that, I would like to end my session. I'm sorry I have overshooted 10 minutes of my time. So I'm sorry, SS. I told you that I'll try to put this topic as fast as possible, but being a technology person, sometimes we need to give time. But then I'm sorry for everyone to take your more 10 to 15 minutes of time in your session where you are at home and listening to me patiently. Thank you. Thank you very much. Over to you, SS.
Yeah, thank you so much for the presentation. And as for the questions, we have some questions that were asked from the audience. So, Sumesh, the first question is, what is the better solution for harmonic rectification?
See, there are two things. Harmonics, as I said, it is the unwanted multiple fundamental frequencies, which is there, the multiple of fundamental frequency. So there are two. One is passive requirement and other is active correction. The passive, as it says, there are passive components like capacitors or inductors, which are tuned. If I'm not going to do the electrical part of it, there are LCR tuned the tuned circuits. So whenever you talk about L, that is inductor, C, capacitor, and resistors. So except resistor, all the two components are effective of frequencies. So by changing the nature of L and C, you're tuning to that frequency. So you are making a low pass circuit for that frequency element, and that will surpass it. So generally, if you observe that you have fifth and seventh harmonic prominently into your circuit, you can go for a passive component. Passive components, which is fixed component, and it can work for a condition where you have a constant voltage, constant load condition. But if your loads are varying, for example, if it is a extruder machine, today it is loaded for 40%, tomorrow it may load for 70%. So there the load is varying from 40 to 70%, there your currents are varying. So at that time, this passive component will not behave the way you want, because it is tuned for maybe 70 to 80% of load capacity. But if load reduces, it will act as a load. It will add to your resonance. If I talk about Harmonics is a big topic. So there is a passive filter which is used by inductors and capacitors and resistors. So there are tank circuit, we call it as. So we tune it for fifth harmonic, seventh harmonics, and we give it. But that is a temporary solution. But if your loads are varying, active solution, which we have said, is the only solution, which is futuristic solution, only solution for you. Apart from correcting your harmonics, it can correct your power factor also, active filters. It can also balance your three-phase load. If there is an imbalance in the load, it can balance your load. So there are only two options. I hope you have answered.
Okay, Sumesh. And Nishant, same person who has the same question, the previous question, he has asked whether what kind of current range do we have? I prefer that you are referring to the harmonic filters.
Yeah.
Yes.
Nishanta, the question is quite valid. This is, we are having right from 60 amperes. We talk about amperes, 60 amperes to 600 amperes. And you can search in Google. No European company, no American company can give you up to 600 amperes. They give it up to 300 amperes only. But we are the only company who has given and installed. It is not only given on paper. We have installed 600 amperes in the actual premises for last 5 years it is working. So up to 600 amperes. So you be assured. Now, of course, with X3 series, we have up to 1,000 amperes. I'm sorry, I was not updated. So it is up to 1,000 amperes we are available. From 60 amperes to 1,000 amperes.
Oh, excuse me, what are the series? X?
We have Iora series. X3 is the latest, which we have in three-level series, which is going up to 1,000 amperes.
1,000 amperes, okay.
But standard, we have Iora standard 3,000, which is available up to 600 amperes. So this is the latest technology of X3 is launched in 2019.
Okay.
So it has a little effect on the cost because it has just launched a new baby. So maybe in another 1 or 2 years, it might get into a normal range of cost. As I said, Fuji is the company who manufactures IGBTs. That is why we are able to give you extra product, extra features, extra power. That's why we are the only company in the world. You can Google it. I will give you a challenge. And if you find it, any company who's manufacturing 1,000 amperes as a single standalone system without paralleling, I will give you one system of 1,000 amperes free of cost. You can record. I think this is a recorded session. I can give it.
Okay, yeah, Nishanta, so I will make sure that our key account executive who is handling your particular company will come and speak to you directly regarding your requirement and your concern. And okay, we'll keep in touch in order to give you more information about it.
Okay, thank you so much. I have one question more. Can I ask?
Please, of course.
My factory have a lot of extruders and roving machines. Actually, I am from Sierra Cable. There is a lot of non-linear loads, and then we can rectify using active or passive filter using for the machines. But when they generate harmonics in the our power system, what are the better solution for all the system? But individually, we can put the filters, passive active filters.
Absolutely. Okay. Nishanta, I'll just tell you, these extruders, generally, if you have extruders for wire drawing, you are in CR cables. I have dealt with Phenolics cable in India. We have dealt with RR cable. There are many cable factories whom we have dealt with. So it is basically, you have a HDPP or high density polypropylene material, which is melted from the furnaces and it flows through your extruder, which is layered onto your copper wire and the copper wire tensile. And I love to know the industry, what you deal into. But to do this, there are generally motors, compressors, and blowing machines. Compressors. These are all machines which are doing the function of the extrusion and or heater also, of course. So these all equipments are driven by a VFD. that is variable frequency drive. Okay, to give you a better control and better efficiency. So whenever these VFDs are working, these are always a 6 pulse VFD. Okay, so 6 pulse will generate almost close to a good 6 pulse VFD. Fiji also is manufacturing a 6 pulse VFD. So we have seen it will give you harmonics of 40 to 50% minimum. A bad VFD can give you up to 80% also, if there is no DC line choke. So that is a different science. So these are VFDs, except the heater in it. Rest, everything is giving you harmonics. So if you have a power analysis in your factory, I think UT can support you on that also. If you want to do a power analysis, they can send you an expert and do a power analysis of your connected load. And you will understand at given PCC, that point of coupling, what is the generation of your harmonics from your operation. And we can guide you. As I said, that IEEE 519 is the Bible for this. So we will understand what is the connected transformer capacity and what is your load current. On that ratio, we can guide you whether you are safe zone or not in the safe zone. So replication, one is to the utility people, they are affected. Your transformer will not be utilized 100%. Third, the internal components which are used for controlling will have lesser life. There was one slide which I have not shown in this. In single phase, the life of the equipment reduces by 38%. This is some analysis done by Europeans. I'm not very sure, but this is authenticated by them. So I'll believe on that. In three phase, the life is reduced to 42%. So whatever the life is reduced by 10 or 15 or 40% doesn't matter. The life is always reduced. So you have to take care about harmonics, not only for the utility issues, but for your internal healthiness. It is like a cancer. It is like a cancer in your factory, but you do not know. A maintenance person will not know what is going wrong. Why my contactor is getting heated up? Why my cables are getting heated? If you see a thermography image of your equipment, you'll find out there is a spots of heating. So that shows that harmonics are fluttering into your system and which is killing your equipment life. So if a life of an equipment is 10 years, if there is harmonics, there is a reduction of 30 to 40% of its life is reduced because of harmonics. So we can do a power analysis. UT has the capability and engineering to them. They can analyze it. They will send me the reports for that. And within one day, we'll give you the entire analysis of your factory premises, what is and where the correction is required. And then you can take a call on that depending on your requirement.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Right, thank you.
Yeah, Sumej, we have another two questions from Nath. I'm not sure if I'm pronounced the name correctly. Regarding the hybrid inverters data sheet, we will share it with you through our key account executive. And Sumej, what is the maximum KVA of 4G hybrid inverter?
Hybrid solar inverter we are talking about, if that question is right. Solar, we have right from 1 kVA as a minimum hybrid inverter. Now, I have not covered that topic in vast. Hybrid inverters, we talk about it is a battery-based primary product, but solar priority. So solar will be the first priority. Second priority can be on grid or battery. And hybrid means it can also pump back to your source. That means if there is an extra generation from your solar and if your load is not consuming it, it can give back to your grid. And you can, if there is a net metering, I think there is no concept of net metering yet in Sri Lanka, or feedback, FIT with feedback tariff. So that is not there in Sri Lanka. But if that comes in future, you can enable that in future. So this hybrid system, you have a provision to enable it in future. So this is available up to 450 kVA. So a big industry can also put it if they have a big roof and if they have a big pocket. Let me tell it very subtly. It is expensive because solar is expensive, but it has a good returns when you talk about long term. So hybrid inverters will store the energy as well as it can export back to your grid wherever it is required. I hope I've answered.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, and thank you, Sumesh. So before, that's all the questions that we have in the Zoom, and also in, we don't have any questions in the Facebook. So before we conclude, I would like to give about 20 seconds for all the, the audience. If you have any questions, please raise and we are ready to answer your questions.
I think one Mr. Mohammed Faziz has asked, when using isolation transform, is it recommended separate neutral earthing in secondary side for proper functioning of ELR in the load side? Yes. See, basically in isolation transformer, when you talk about the secondary is always floating. You will not have true earthing there. So if your load requires a potential of 1 volt as per the load requirement, then you can neutral the earth. So, but that earth should not be common to your building earth. It should be a dedicated earth. The earth, there is an earthing topic also. We can talk in elaboration, have a topic to discuss on that. But yes, for isolation transformer, output is floating. But if your equipment requires neutral to earth to be less than 1 volt, then that floating neutral you have to earth to a dedicated earth, not to the building earth. I hope I have answered Mohammed Fazvi. Sorry.
Yeah, Fazvi, do you have any questions?
Yeah. My question is when that is our TT system,
yeah.
If it's isolated, the ELR may not function properly, you know, due to the earth loop impedance, improper earth loop impedance. That
yes.
is my question.
No, that is what I said. For ELRs, for even for the differential breakers also, the sensitivity will define. Okay. So whenever you want to do an earthing to neutral, you need to have a dedicated earth for that, so that your potential is always near to zero. Then the ELR will look. But if you give it to the building earth, it will not, because building earth is always having a potential higher than 1 volt. Am I there?
Yeah. Okay, thank you for your answer.
Okay, thank you.
Any other questions? Yeah, okay, thank you. And before we wind out, I would like to thank all the people who have attended for this session, in order to get valuable knowledge from Sumesh. And Sumesh, thank you for sharing your valuable information that is for all the customers and clients and even people who have joined for this webinar. So, and I would like to invite everyone to like our UT Learning Center Facebook webpage and also the UT ECAT Facebook webpage in order to get updates about the future webinars that we are going to conduct in the near future. And thank you, Sumesh, once again, and thank you all for joining for the session. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Ayu Bhavan to everyone. This is the only word I have learned, sorry. I will learn more Sri Lankese, and I love the cuisines of Sri Lanka. And I would have hoopes, I'll have fish curry, I'll have everything. I mean, I would love to come back and be with you all guys and discuss your problems. Thank you very much. Good night.